Hello, it's Jennifer from Sea Lemon. In this video, I've teamed up with SuGru to show you 5 different ways you can use this awesome moldable glue in your DIY projects. I will tell you up front, this is a sponsored video, but I honestly love this brand and their product, so I wanted to share it with you guys. In case you don't know what this stuff is, SuGru is a moldable glue. It feels like Play-Doh, it's easy to shape, mold, and it pretty much sticks to everything. It turns into a tough, flexible rubber overnight, making it easy and fun for anyone to fix, adapt, and improve the stuff in their life. SuGru also makes the perfect gift, and special bonus for you guys, if you want to try this out, you can get a 10% discount on everything in the SuGru shop. Just see that offer link in the description below. There are endless possibilities to the things you can fix and make with SuGru, so here are 5 DIYs to get you started. There are many tools that can often hurt your hands after using them for a while, which takes the fun out of making things. These tools usually hurt my hand after a while, so I'm going to add SuGru to the grips. With this orange SuGru, I'm going to flatten it and then put my awl on the middle of it and roll it on the grip portion, and rolling it in my hands to spread it out and achieve an even surface. You may notice the color comes off a little on your hands, but it is super easy to clean off with a piece of tissue. Now onto my hole puncher, I'm using the green SuGru and just sticking it onto the grip. I want this to be a comfortable fit for my hand, so I'm custom fitting it to my fingers. And by using a different color on the other side, I can automatically know which side is the top. So I'm shaping the gray side to fit the palm of my hand, which will make it a more comfortable grip. Now I'm going to let the SuGru dry for 24 hours, and I found it easy to let them hang somewhere, like my lamp post, while they dry. The next day, the SuGru has set and the grips are much more comfortable on my hands. I think this improves the quality of my art supplies, and you could add SuGru to just about any tool to customize or improve the quality of the handles and grips. Next, I'll show you an easy way to make a custom stamp using a bottle cap and SuGru. Roll 1 pack of SuGru into a ball and press it down flat onto your bottle cap. Press it out flat and then use something like a toothpick to emboss your design onto the SuGru. I'm going with a lemon on this one, so I'm just drawing out a lemon slice while pressing down at the same time. Then lightly press it down with your finger or lightly push it onto a tabletop so that the surface is all on the same level and you'll see the design when you stamp it. Then let it sit to dry for 24 hours. Then when it's completely dry, it's ready to stamp. I brushed on some yellow paint and stamped it onto this blue piece of paper to make a fun pattern of lemon slices. And FYI, the stamp washes off really easily because once SuGru is dry, it's waterproof. You may recognize this marbled key from a previous tutorial. As you can see, the paint is wearing off, so I removed all of the paint and I will show you another way to customize your keys using SuGru and a marble technique. To make the most out of 2 packs, I'm going to combine a piece of the red and white to form a third color. So with this piece of white and red, I'm just going to squidge it around and blend it until it forms a solid pink. Now form those 3 colors into rolls and twist them together to form 1 large roll. Then fold that in half and roll that together into another roll. And repeat that step, rolling it and folding it until you achieve a marble that you like. Then take off 1 piece and push it onto the key. You want to smooth it on lightly because SuGru can blend easily together, so to keep that marbled look, just touch it lightly. Then blend on another piece to the other side, and use something like a toothpick to form the opening. 2 packs of SuGru will customize about 2 to 3 keys, and a spool of thread makes the perfect holder to let them dry. After 24 hours, my marbled keys are ready to go. The texture of the SuGru makes a nice grip on these, and you can try this technique with any of the colors. For this next project, I'm going to make a simple jewelry holder. I put some patterned paper in a photo frame and used 1 pack of SuGru to form the hooks. I'm making 3 total, so I'm going to divide it into 3 sections, and from each section, pull off a little dot to put onto the glass. This will help the hook stick to the surface. Then form the holder into any shape you want. I'm going with a hook, but you could also try like a heart shape or anything you want, and then just press it onto that dot. After 24 hours has passed and the SuGru is all dry, I can then use it to hold my necklaces. Not only is this a functional display for your jewelry, but it also makes a cool piece of art to hang on your wall. For the book enthusiasts out there, SuGru can also help repair and customize your book covers. This is an old sketchbook of mine, and as you can see, the corners and edges are showing a bit of wear. So to preserve those edges, I'm going to use some Sugru on the book cover. Place some scrap paper between the cover and the pages, and press on some Sugru to make protective corners. The size of the corners is up to your preference. This also works on the spine of books because it does dry flexible. For a finishing touch, I'm going to archive this book by adding a piece of Sugru to the cover and embossing the year when I use the sketchbook. The Sugru is dry and protecting my book cover. And you can see that it's flexible so that when you open your book cover, it really doesn't interfere with your book. You can also try making different decorative elements with the Sugru and using different colors to make a design on your cover. Hit that like button if you enjoyed those DIYs and you now want to apply Sugru to just about everything in your life. Head to sugru.com for loads more project ideas and inspiration, and discover how Sugru can help you adapt and improve your stuff. And I will see you guys next time.